Hello and welcome to Error Reporting Web. In this video I will be using Symfony with API platform and I'm going to make a file port without using any additional packages or components. I'm not even going to be using any database or doctrine so we can go faster through the code. First I'm going to start with some scaffolding, so if you want to skip to the good stuff just check the video description. Right here I have a brand new installation of Symfony Skeleton, and behind the scenes I just installed the API platform package. Like I said, we're not going to be using doctrine or any entities, so I will open the configuration of API platform and I'm going to change the path where API platform reads the annotation. I'm going to call this folder resource. So let's create this. Inside the project root into the source folder, I will create a new directory called resource. For the example purposes of this video, I will be using a book resource, and we will have a title and cover image, which will be our file port. So inside this new folder, I will create a new class called book, and at the top of the file, I will add the API platform annotations. So API platform will recognize that we want this class to be a resource. Now let's add the book properties. First we will have an integer for the ID. Then let's add a string for a title. And finally our cover image is going to be the appalled. I will type in this with appalled file, and these are all the fields that our book is going to have. Now let's just add annotations to them. This way API platform will recognize that each of these properties is part of the request and the response of our book. Finally, we just need to tell API platform that our identifier is the ID. Now let's go to the browser and open the API page. As expected, we have a list of all the book endpoints added here. Now let's start handling the file upload request. We will do this inside a custom action. So inside the controllers folder, I'm going to create a new class called book post action. This will be the file that the book post endpoint is going to hit, and here we will handle all of the file port inside the invoke method. For now I will just die here with a message we are here so we can test this endpoint. Now let's tell API platform that we want to hit this new action that we just created. To do this we need to override the collection operations. And the method for creating a book is called post. Here I will open brackets and I want to override some of these properties. Let's start by confirming that the request method we want is post. Next, let's point this request to our controller. Book post action. And finally, let's tell this endpoint to disable the deserialization. I will tell you more about this when we get to the file port. Now to finish this, let's import the book post action. It's time to make our test request to this endpoint. And since I'm using PHP Storm as my IDE, I really like how the built-in request tool works. So let's use that. Inside the project root, I'm going to add a new folder called requests, and let's create a HTTP request called book. This will be a post request to our endpoint. And let's send it and see what response do we get. Okay, that's our debug message. We are here, so we know that this works. Let's start working on the actual file port. First I will inject the book here. This comes automatically from API platform. And as a second parameter, I want to include the request, which is where we will get our file from. So let's do that right now. I will create a variable called uploaded file. And using the request files, I will try to get a cover image, which is the name of the parameter for the uploaded file. Now let's do a basic validation. If we do not have an uploaded file, let's just die. We need a file upload. Now if you remember, I said deserialize to false here. And I did this so API platform won't try to manually fill any of the data and remove the file upload from the request. Now after we just handle the file upload, we need to manually fill all the other properties inside the book. So I believe we have only one that's called title, and we'll get this from the request. Now let's fill the file upload as well. This is the cover image and we'll assign it to the uploaded file. Finally, API platform expects this book to have an ID, and since we're not using any database and we're not storing the data, let's assign an arbitrary ID of 1 to this resource and return the data. We're finally ready to try this request again. As expected, we get you need a file upload error, which is our super basic validation. So let's send a file with our request. I will use the FPTR wife template, which will give us this great example of file upload. I will start filling all the fields, and starting with the URL. Our endpoint is api/books. Our field name is cover image. We'll leave the file name to file.txt, and let's fetch its data from the current folder. So I will copy this request into file.txt, and I will add its contents to be hello there. Finally, we just need our title. So I will duplicate this web boundary and add another field called title. We won't have a file, and the contents will be my awesome book. So now let's make another request, and we successfully get a response from API platform with our title and our cover image. So this is how to do a super fast and basic file upload. At this point, you can do anything with this file. You can move it, you can write it to the disk, or send it to a CDN or another service. Let me know below in the comments if you have any suggestions or ideas how to improve this. This was all for this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.